Now, here's Chief Meteorologist Tony Petrarca with your Pinpoint Weather 12 forecast.
Well, I received a couple of emails from people who work outdoors, and they said, boy, they really felt it today. 93 degrees, the high temperature this afternoon, but it was definitely not a dry heat. Of course, you know, the humidity, the mugginess in the air as well. So a lot of these temperatures actually felt more like 98 to almost 100, the heat index, or that feel like temperature. I don't think we'll hit 93 tomorrow, but we'll certainly get into the upper 80s. And with the humidity still in place, it'll still be very warm to borderline hot. It made it to 84 in Newport. In fact, the above average temperatures, the high humidity really extending through the next 5 to 7 days, through at least the middle of next week. The fans, the air conditioners still going here. You know, tough sleeping at night with you know, the nighttime temperature staying well into the 70s to almost 80, even at the midnight hour, and that humidity makes the temperatures feel warmer, and that humidity leading to a little bit of at least some light fog down in places like Easton's Beach and Newport. It tends to be more prevalent as you get closer to the ocean, and any of this really thins out by tomorrow morning. Visibility is better in North Kingstown right now under partly cloudy conditions. Temperatures in most areas are in the upper 70s, kind of that tropical feel over New England with into next week, as the airflow is coming right out of the Bahamas and the subtropics right up the East Coast and into New England with the warm temps and the high humidity. Shower chances, I mean, they're small tomorrow. I wouldn't call it non-zero. But it is, I wouldn't call it zero, but it is certainly small. Saturday afternoon, I think the better chance of a scattered shower or thunderstorm, though the day as a whole doesn't look like a washout, but that's probably the better chance. And keeping an eye on the beaches, I mean, great beach weather, some sunshine tomorrow, but the rip currents have been on the increase, and that'll be the general rule over the next several days. So be mindful of that. You know, call ahead. Some of the beaches are open, but they kind of have restrictions to swimming. Some beaches, not all. You can see what's left of the showers we had earlier this evening, just fizzling out right now. I don't anticipate much in the way of shower activity overnight. You see some lightning strikes near New York City, but you can see the next area of rain coming up from the Carolinas, but it looks like the thrust of this is going to pass just to our north and west tomorrow. So while I wouldn't rule out an isolated shower, especially well north and west of Providence, I just think a better part of the day tomorrow is actually rain-free, as that moisture is still embedded within this high humidity, this darker green up and down the East Coast. The dew points represents that Caribbean air, that the tropical air. Getting real close, forecast overnight. Temperatures are in the 70s all night long. Any early morning clouds will give way to breaks of sunshine. And once the sunshine gets to work in the afternoon, we're talking about temperatures that'll reach the middle to upper 80s. All right, 7 day forecast. Again, scattered showers on Saturday. It's a cooler day in the sense that it's not in the 90s. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a cool day, just cooler than the last couple, but still warm and humid. A brief shower or downpour in the afternoon, but not a washout. Back to sunshine, hot on Sunday near 90, and the heat and the humidity continue into early next week. So many activities going on this weekend, and just a brief interruption on Saturday afternoon, but overall the next 3 days looking pretty good. Just kind of take a slow frozen lemonade day.
You're talking about people working outside, just people at events, golfing and everything else. It was difficult.
Yeah. Today.